Hey, how's it going? Dave2D here. So traditionally, when it comes to buying gaming laptops, the CPU is a pretty easy decision. I mean, there's just not that many choices to choose from. So last year, it was the i7-7700HQ, and if you couldn't afford that, you'd get the i5. And the year before that, it was the 6700HQ, and it's just always been really few options, which was a kind of a good thing because it just made the process a lot easier. But right now, in 2018, for whatever reason, there's so many good CPU options for gaming laptops. We already have the 8th gen U processors, the Kaby Lake R's, and those are quad-core 15-watt packages. And if you pair that up with an MX150, which a lot of laptops do, you actually get a pretty respectable gaming laptop. It's not like a hardcore gaming laptop, but you can play a lot of games with really respectable frame rates. And as long as the laptop is cooled properly, which not every company does, but if it is, you're good to go for like light to moderate gaming. Now, the H processors coming out are more exciting. The i9 is gonna be nutty, but the two more common ones are these two, the i7 and the i5. That i7 looks ripe. 6 cores, strong turbo, and it's in the same 45-watt package as the previous generation, so you don't have to have any kind of crazy thermal solution. And we've seen some preliminary benchmarks pop up, and it really does look promising. Compared to the current i7-7700HQ, it's like 30 to 35% better for multi-core benchmarks. Now, in the past, a lot of developers haven't put in the time to optimize their games for just more than 4 CPU cores, but because of Ryzen last year and just the state of the industry now where core count is kind of creeping up slowly, I think companies will put in the time. So there's another batch of CPUs made by Intel, the Kaby Lake-G, and there's 5 of them. These are kind of a collab between Intel and AMD. So they're running Intel CPUs with an AMD VEGA GPU. There's 2 different GPUs, the VEGA MGL and the VEGA MGH, GH being the stronger, more powerful one of the two. The performance is good, like really good for the wattage, and I think that's its biggest advantage, efficiency. It's energy efficient, it's space efficient because they're packing the CPU, the GPU, and the VRAM all onto one chip. It's still not an APU, it's a CPU and a dedicated GPU, but it's just packaged into one thing, so you can build something that's smaller, thinner, and lighter than a laptop that uses a discrete GPU from NVIDIA. Now, the preliminary benchmarks have been pretty interesting. We're looking at something between a 1050 and a 1050 Ti for the GL, and then for the GH, the better one, the performance is gonna be something around a GTX 1060. And they'll both be quite energy efficient, but the big disadvantage I see with these is pricing. The GH model in particular is gonna start at like 1200 bucks, maybe even more, and you're getting, remember, GTX 1060 performance for $1,200. And I feel like at that price point, you can get something that's like a 1070 from NVIDIA. It's gonna be thicker, it's gonna be louder, it's gonna be bigger, but you're gonna get better performance for your money. The last ones are the AMD chips. So they have 8-core and 6-core Ryzen laptops that are using these desktop CPUs, which are really powerful, but I mean, they're desktop CPUs, so that doesn't really count in this conversation. They're also just stupidly expensive. The ones that are most interesting to me are their new Ryzen Mobile APUs, and their integrated GPUs on these things are so much better than the integrated Intel GPUs, like the HD 630 or even the UHD 630. It's just miles ahead of the Intel integrated GPUs. It benchmarks well, but the games are just so poorly optimized with these drivers that it just looks like a crappy card. If they can fix those drivers, and they will, but if they can fix it quickly enough, it'll be a strong competitor for casual gaming. And if you see what devices they're putting these into, like we're talking ultrabooks and just really thin devices, it's pretty cool. You can bring something like this to school, to work, and just kind of kick it for some light gaming at home. So this video has been filled with tons of like nerd numbers and stuff like that. I'm just gonna break it down really simple. Right now, if you're looking for a CPU for a gaming laptop, there's obviously a lot of choices to choose from. It's obviously harder this year to choose one than last year. If you want something that's like the best of the best and you have the money, then the i7 and the i9 that's popping out from Intel soon will be a good bet. But if you have something like a smaller budget and you're just looking for a thinner device that gets decent gaming performance, take a look at the Kaby Lake-G from Intel. So these are the Intel CPUs comboed with the AMD VEGA GPUs. It's good performance and you should comfortably break 60 frames per second for most games. And if you don't care too much about image quality or resolution, you can drop down to a U processor paired up with the NVIDIA MX150. But if you want something that's like really budget and you're looking for something that's like thin and light that doesn't cost too much, those upcoming Ryzen Mobile APUs should be pretty good. Some of them are already out, it's just that the drivers aren't great, and if you just give it some time for them to flesh out, I think they can be great for just the casual gamer with a smaller budget. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hope it clarified some things. Thumbs if you liked it, subs if you loved it. See you guys next time.